Hi, I'm Beth. This is Amber, and we're going to demonstrate pose of the month, which is downward facing dog. So Amber's going to start out here in tabletop. And the nice thing about starting here as a demonstration for how to get into down dog is that she has this really beautiful alignment. The top of her head is in line with her tailbone, and her spine is really long. And now she's just going to press down through her hands, curl her toes, and lift her hips up, and then press back. So really a nice, gentle way to get into downward facing dog. Points to consider and keep in mind are that her fingers are spread wide and her entire palm is pressing into the mat for stability. Her knees are bent. Her back is still lengthy. She can press back a little bit more through her shoulders. That lengthened her neck a little bit and gave her just a little bit more space. So her chest is broad, shoulders are wide. You can experiment with how far apart you want your feet to be. We usually cue about shoulders width apart, but if it feels good to experiment with that, definitely try it out. Now bend your knees a little bit, Amber. Really come down low. And then lift your hips again and just lengthen your back. Just even doing that a couple of times as you find your downward facing dog is going to change the feel of this. Every time you come back to down dog in your practice, you're going to notice something different, and it's fine to shift and move and kind of explore what's available to you. Big fan of the knee bend. Takes the pressure off your low back and really allows you to access more here. You want to be sure you are in this upside down triangle, not in a really awkward half push-up. Can you just demonstrate that? This is sometimes where people land in downward facing dog. This is miserable, so don't pick this. Just press back, let your head drop and your neck lengthen. That is the pose of the month, downward.